on the first day of summer, Summer McIntosh from Etobicoke as well, originally training at the National Swim Center now.
Again, Summer McIntosh is in lane three.
Summer McIntosh has been going 104s. I don't think this is going to be a problem. She should make the standard, no problem.
Here comes Summer McIntosh touching the wall for 800 in 8:29.48. She's done it by 4 seconds.
Eric Brown had a really great 400 meter freestyle. Giant breakout for him. You see Eric Brown, he was breathing on his left side going down to our right. Now that he's coming back, he's breathing on his right side.
I would think you have to kind of go into like a Zen state almost here. 15:57 is the personal best for Eric Brown. It's 16 flat for Alex Axon. So his personal best, 15:57. It's going to be blown out of the water at 15:19.6.
Sydney Pickram, the woman we were talking about, 7 international medals already to her credit. And the interesting thing that happens in an individual medley is usually everybody has a bit of a weak stroke. Kelsey Watt is a world-class breaststroker, as is Sydney Pickram, so they both usually labor. Kelsey more on the breaststroke, making a big, big move in lane number three. That's 4 from the bottom. Bailey Anderson from Smith Falls, Ontario, has a good breaststroke. She had a great breakout swim at a meet in the United States about 6 weeks ago, so she's in a position now to challenge for that Olympic berth. But the veteran Pickram has had this race in her back pocket the whole way.
Sydney Pickram approaches. Who's going to get second? It's Pickram for first. It's Watt for second.
Finley Knox is certainly the man that most people think can destroy this Olympic qualifying time. This is Finley against the clock. There's nobody else really going to be very close to him, I don't think. But the interesting thing that he and his coach Ben Titley have been doing is they've been throwing him in 100 butterfly races to get his butterfly stronger.
Over in lane six, Cole Pratt is almost even.
Well, I think the stroke that Finley would say is his weakest stroke is backstroke, and we saw that. Both those other two guys are world-class backstrokers, so they made a big move in the backstroke. But unfortunately, those two guys aren't quite as good in the breaststroke.
Finley Knox touches in 129.87, less than 50 meters to go in the freestyle. And now the lead is really growing for Finley Knox. And here comes Finley Knox to the wall at 158.07. He is way below the standard. The only one under 2 minutes. Second place was Cole Pratt.
Kyla Sanchez is the one with the best chance of possibly getting to the Olympic standard. Always smiling, can't see it behind the mask, but she's always in a good mood, always ready to go.
Kyla Sanchez in lane four.
Gotta say, as Kyla was off the blocks a little bit slow, if she misses by hundreds, that'll maybe be the difference. But boy, is she powering now. 24:77 is the time to watch in the bottom if she makes it.
Kyla Sanchez has got the lead. She's gonna touch the wall first. She does in 24:68. And Brent Hayden, who holds the Canadian record in this event at 21:73. Men's 53-1, super fast lap of the pool. Liendo and Hayden, and that seems to be the challenge right now. Brent Hayden just battling there with Liendo. They're neck and neck, reaching for the wall. Hayden got there first in 21:82.
You saved 19 seconds off your personal best time. How do you describe that, Summer?
Well, definitely my training has gone up a lot this year. I've been trying to work harder than I ever have, and I knew that I got out in the 835 in my 1500, so I know that I could do a really good 800.
Outstanding.
I've been focusing a lot on the distance events, you know, day in, day out. I'm just working on this moment right now because this is my big race, and every set I've done, you know, it's just leading up to this moment, so I was really happy I was able to do that today.
I'm really happy with it right now, just to go and get back into racing and just try and execute a good race. Had no time that I wanted to do, no specific outcome goal, but just execute the best race I could today. And I'm pretty happy with it. I mean, those girls, I knew they were gunning for that time, so I knew they'd push me, and it is what it is, and I'm happy with it. It's a step in the process.
It was a good swim. We'll look back at the tape and see what we can work on, but pleased with the time and just happy to be racing again.
No kidding. Tell me about that. It's been a long journey, and to put this performance together in this pressure-packed situation has to feel good.
Yeah, definitely. Leading up, definitely a little anxious, but just being able to have competition and being able to race is just amazing. I love it.
I'm really happy with it. I wasn't super happy with how I did yesterday and just want to get up and rip a fast one. So I'm happy.
It feels absolutely amazing. It's like, when I came out of retirement, like, you know, I just wanted to fall back in love with the sport again, and I'm having the time of my life right now. I mean, obviously I'm not with my beautiful wife right now, who's back home, but baby, I love you so much.